In the Myeloma Made Simple series, we have discussed the importance of immunotherapy, where we employ a patient's own immune system to fight their myeloma. One of the newest ways to do this is with bispecific antibodies. These are off-the-shelf drugs that bring together the myeloma cell and a local immune cell. They do so by their bi- or twofold nature, to bind an antigen on the surface of the myeloma cell and to an immune cell at the same time. As they do this, they activate the immune cell, usually a T cell, to destroy the myeloma cell. In this video, I will explore the differences between the many bispecific antibodies, or bispecifics, that are based on the antigen or target on the surface of the myeloma cell. This is an important concept. It allows the bispecific to target different antigens on the surface of the myeloma cell, and therefore expands our ability to treat patients with myeloma. The three targets I will discuss are BCMA, or B-cell maturation antigen, GPRC5D, G-protein coupled receptor family C group 5 member D, and FCRH5, Fc receptor homolog 5. While all bispecific antibodies share the common feature and side effects, they differ significantly based on the antigen that they target on the myeloma cell. BCMA, the most prevalent antigen on myeloma cells, is an ideal target due to its heavy expression or presence. The goal is to target myeloma cells without affecting healthy cells. BCMA plays a critical role in cell survival, making it a valuable target for cells destruction. Furthermore, BCMA's versatility in immunotherapy extends beyond bispecific antibodies to include antibody-drug conjugates and CAR T-cell therapy. The first two FDA-approved bispecific antibodies for myeloma are teclistamab, also known as Tecvayli, and elranatamab, Elrexfio. They are both approved for patients who have had at least 4 prior lines of therapy, including a proteasome inhibitor, an immunomodulatory agent, and a monoclonal antibody. Both agents have demonstrated impressive activity in heavily pretreated patients with response rates in the range of 60 to 70%. As described in the video Bispecific Antibodies Made Simple, these drugs can cause CRS, or cytokine release syndrome, and ICANS, immune effector cell-associated neurotoxicity syndrome. That's why these drugs must be administered at an approved location, and patients must be closely monitored for potential side effects. Long-term effects include infections. Therefore, patients may require close monitoring of blood counts, immunoglobulin levels, and potential intravenous immunoglobulin delivery. The second antigen that can be targeted on a myeloma cell by a bispecific antibody is GPRC5D. This is also heavily expressed on myeloma cells, but we also see it on the skin, on the nails, in the hair, and in the taste buds. One bispecific antibody that is approved that targets GPRC5D is talquetamab, or Talve. It is approved for patients who have had at least 4 prior lines of therapy, including a proteasome inhibitor, an immunomodulatory agent, and a monoclonal antibody. It is administered much like the BCMA-targeted bispecifics, but it may be given less frequently. It demonstrates a response rate of over 70% in patients with heavily pretreated disease. Unique side effects associated with GPRC5D include a reduction in taste, a loss of nails, thinning of the hair, and peeling of the skin. We are still working toward finding ways to reduce the severity of these side effects. Often it does require dose adjustment, yet talquetamab may have slightly lower risk of infections than BCMA-directed bispecific antibodies. The third target on the myeloma cell is FCRH5. This is also strongly expressed on myeloma cells and is an attractive means for bispecific antibodies to latch onto myeloma cells. Currently, no bispecific antibodies that target FCRH5 are approved, but there are drugs in development, including cevostamab. The future of bispecific antibodies is bright, with several being developed to target myeloma. Interestingly, some are even being developed to engage immune cells other than T cells, such as natural killer or NK cells. In summary, the class of bispecific antibodies has become a critical part of therapy in myeloma. We now have at least 3 antigens or targets on the myeloma cell that these agents can use to engage T cells to treat multiple myeloma. We also anticipate with time that these agents will be able to be used even earlier in the disease course. Clinical trials are even ongoing with these agents in frontline therapy.